Oh man, I love football. I mean, the first day I started playing it, I mean, I was where I went to grade school, you couldn't put pads on until fifth grade, and I couldn't wait. And one thing I was mad about was there was a weight limit, and I couldn't get under it, so I had to lose some weight, you know, to play with the ball in my hands. So I had to play on the line. Still loved it, but I remember putting my pads on, standing in the mirror in my bedroom, like, this is awesome, you know. Always loved it. I love and respect this game. I mean, I wouldn't be who I am or where I'm at without the game of football. Why you do this game gets tested all the time. And there's all kinds of things that happen, you know, but never why, you know, why you love the game of football. I mean, we talked about it today as a staff. I mean, none of us would be where we are. We wouldn't be married. We wouldn't have kids. We wouldn't be the people we are if we hadn't fell in love with this game.
In America, we make our own decisions and enjoy freedom of choice. For too long, power companies have put profits first, and customers and the environment last. At Power Home Solar, we'll build a world where homes and businesses run on affordable, clean, renewable solar energy. A world we're proud to pass to our children. We're an American company using American-made panels. We're building a movement. One business, one home, one panel at a time. Power Home Solar. Own your power.
I see a race car. I see a dinosaur.
Hey, Lou, what do you see?
I see a house with a CPI security system, fully equipped with smart video, intrusion protection, and real-time response.
Whoa, cool.
Protect your home with smarter security from CPI. Stop imagining peace of mind. You'll never miss a thing, and one app controls it all. Make CPI yours today. To learn more, go to mycpi.com.
Luke, my T-Rex is going into your house.
He's gonna set off the alarm.
At Strategic Systems, we understand that a reliable IT infrastructure doesn't just materialize by itself. We've been helping Triangle businesses of all sizes build and manage secure, reliable technology solutions for over 25 years. Strategic Systems and CEI. Are you transforming your business?
To playing a home game. It's been a month since we've been back in Carter-Finley and excited for homecoming. Night game opportunity against a tremendous football team. And it's what you play for, you know, to play against such a good team, such a well-coached team, and to get to do it at home in a night environment at the Carter. It's been awesome to have those types of games, and look forward to having one. I know we'll have a tremendous crowd. I love a challenge, and love when my back's up against the wall. And I know this, our guys aren't going to flinch. They're going to fight. And we're going to fight as a program to get better. And I think the biggest thing that for us, it's not who we play. It's what we do to get better every day and how we play.
With the number of lineup changes we've had to go through because of the injuries, it's all about trying to be better than we were the week before without continuity. And so it's a weekly challenge to do that, you know, and this week's no different, you know. So it's just, we haven't had the same lineup all season, you know. So to say that we want to be better this week than last week, when you have the same 22 and you're too deep, you can do that. You know, that's been the biggest challenge of the season, to be honest, is just there isn't any continuity from week to week, whether it's an offense or a defense or a special team unit, which changes your ability to get better and better. Now, you're seeing individual improvement throughout the roster, but you want to see the collective unit get better, and that's where we're focusing here for these last 4 weeks. Playing hard isn't an issue. It's executing consistently over a long period of time. You know, we'll have 10 guys do it right, one guy do it wrong, and that's where the issue happens, and that's just the type of team we are. I mean, you'll turn on a team like Clemson, and they'll bust a coverage. A guy will run down the field with no one on him, and they sack the quarterback. Well, if we bust a coverage right now, they throw a touchdown on us. I mean, we're just not getting – balls don't bounce to us. We're not staying healthy. We're going through a lot, you know, and so we have to coach and play as good, as perfect as we can right now. Like, the margin for error, you just have to assume there isn't any, and that's fine. You know, that's what we're up against, but that's the week-to-week process that we're going through, is – trying to get young guys to play older, and the accumulation of reps allows that to happen. And I saw that last week with Jordan Houston, with Drake Thomas, Peyton Wilson. I think they played their best games. And I told the team, put me in a corner and let me fight my way out of it. I love that opportunity. Tell me I can't do something. I want to prove you wrong. Like, that's how I am. That's the type of person I am. I like guys that are like that. You know, is everyone like that on our team? No. You know, you've got to convince and talk some guys into their motivational things to remind them of their whys and do that. But there are some guys that, man, all they want to do is go beat somebody. They're going to do everything they can, and when they lose, it hurts them to their core. And so that's what we want. We want as many guys like that as we can get.
Newman sends a wide receiver in motion. They fake the fly sweep, and Newman's in trouble. He's going to be sacked. Sacked by Drake Thomas. Hits the rugby punt. And it will be fielded by Thayer Thomas at the 25. He moves left, now right, and up the middle to the 40-yard line, 45, 50, 45, 40, to the 30-yard line. He's going to go all the way, 10, 5, touchdown, Thayer Thomas, 75 yards.
So I played for the North Raleigh Bulldogs, the Pop Warner team in North Raleigh. I started when I was 5, and my dad was like an assistant coach my first year. He wasn't really the head guy. And then my second year, he really took over as the head coach. But you can't really play until you're 5. So Drake was like 2 years behind. So Drake would come to every practice and participate in our practices at 3 years old. And he would practice with us. And then on game day, he would just be on the sideline, like probably was like a water boy type.
Yeah, I dressed up and everything like for like game days and stuff. I was just like technically wasn't allowed to play. But like one game at the end of the season, my dad put me into the game when I was like 4 years old. So
you put him in illegally?
Yeah, I played deep safety. That's what they said when they would put me out there when I was 3.
Well, I think football's in our blood. You know, we always grew up. I remember specifically watching, you know, my dad played with Troy Brown, and we would follow the Patriots, you know. We went to 2 preseason games when they came to Carolina the year after they won the Super Bowl in 2004. And so we got to meet Troy Brown, and you know, we got to meet Ty Law back when he was playing for the Patriots. And you know, my dad just sort of surrounded us with, you know, football, watching football on Sundays, Saturdays and stuff like that, and going to different college games. I remember me asking my dad if I could play football. It wasn't, you know, my dad telling me I need to play football.
Yeah, we were always around it growing up when we were little, and you know, we wanted to get out there on the field. It wasn't that he pushed us to get out there.
Saying that we're family, but then having family members on the team is unique. You know, the Dabbs brothers, the Thomas brothers, the McKay brothers. I mean, it's neat walking behind them as they go to the practice field and seeing these two brothers with their pads on talking, and like, how awesome is that? You know, that every Thanksgiving for the rest of their lives, they're going to have those memories of playing college football together. I think it's awesome, and I think it says a lot about our program, you know, because obviously if one brother comes and 2 years later, another brother comes, that tells you there's good things happening, or the parents would be like, well, I'm not letting my other one go there, you know? I mean, no, they want them here because of how their sons are being treated, coached, mentored, developed, and I think that's great for our program.
So back probably 8 years ago, football was a little bit different than it is today, like especially youth football. You know, my dad has to head it, like tackling drills, like every single day at practice. It doesn't matter, it's the day before the game.
Full go,
to the ground. Tackling drills to the ground. And so we would do this one specifically, it was called King of the Ring. And so it was like a 4x4, you would put cones, it was like a four corner cones, and you would get two guys in the middle, and whoever drove each other out of the ring, you know, wins. And so I think that he would split it up into four groups throughout the whole team. So it was like, you know, 10 guys here, 10 guys here, 10 guys here, 10 guys here. And the winner of each group would come to the middle to like the final four. And so, you know, I would usually, if I didn't make it to the final four, it was like, you know, it was a, like I needed to do it just so I could try to impress my dad. And then I felt like I needed to do it. So, but when Drake was there one time, he made it to the final four with me and these other kids, but he matched us up. And I was, at the time, I was probably bigger than Drake.
Yeah, I was like 5, and he was like, I was like 6, and he was like 8 or something like that.
Yeah, probably turning 9 or something. I was just bigger, just more physically bigger than him. And I remember driving him, like I won. And then like he was on the ground, and I kept driving him into the ground like 5 seconds after the drill was over.
He didn't stop.
And I didn't stop. And I remember he was like crying, and I was like, my dad was like, what are you doing? Like, because I just wanted to, I don't know, I just wanted to beat my little brother. And that was probably like one of the only times I actually, you know, was able to drive him into the ground, because obviously now it would probably be a little bit different.
I mean, we would like wrestle or something in the house. He couldn't beat me. He couldn't. He's never been able to beat me in like if like we were fighting or like wrestling or something since.
I wouldn't say either of us honestly won. It sort of ended in like a tie. Yeah. But I would say the one thing I do remember was when I was a junior in high school and he came into high school as a freshman. You know, he had all these senior and old upperclassmen, you know, thinking they're really good at football and stuff. And I'm just like, I knew how good he was at football, and I was like telling them that he was going to play varsity. And they're like, yeah, right. Like, and then ended up by the first game, he was a starting linebacker as a true freshman. So his first varsity game was actually my first varsity game, because I wasn't fortunate enough coming into high school being, you know, as giftedly, as, you know, big as some of these other kids were. So I had to play JV, but he ended up was able to play varsity right out of middle school.
Seeing what he's like, you know, done and the work he put in, and the fact that he was still going to continue to get better, bigger, faster, stronger, and I mean, there's just like no doubt in my mind that he's going to be able to come in and you know, earn a spot and get playing time and get a scholarship. And when he first got here, it was definitely good to hear from the coaches and stuff that he was doing well, and he was definitely turning some heads and making an impact.
I see a dinosaur.
Hey Lou, what do you see?
I see a house with a CPI security system, fully equipped with smart video, intrusion protection, and real-time response.
Whoa, cool.
Protect your home with smarter security from CPI. Stop imagining peace of mind. You'll never miss a thing, and one app controls it all. Make CPI yours today. To learn more, go to mycpi.com.
Lou, my T-Rex is going into your house.
He's gonna set off the alarm.
Get 0 for 72 on select F-150s or get $11,500 in total savings at your Carolina Ford dealer.
For years, you've relied on your electric cooperative to power your daily life. Now, we're going one step further. North Carolina's electric cooperatives are building a network of electric vehicle charging stations across the state, boosting tourism and economic opportunities, reducing emissions, and empowering our members with the latest technology. Learn more at ncdriveelectric.com.
Here you go. You look sleepy. This should be the best part of your day. Practice should be like breakfast for you, the most important thing. Here you go.
Overall, guys just want to win. They want to win games. I think my group's attitude is positive. I think they've been pushing each other, but at the end of the day, you know, I think we live in a generation now where kids want like immediate results of things. And so we hadn't had that the last couple of weeks. And so I think they're just chomping at the bit. We're gonna have a chance to face Clemson at home this week. And they're just constantly, they had a mindset of just proving people wrong. You know, they want another opportunity to go out there and play some more football.
We need reps. We need reps at this. Malik, you had a beautiful opportunity after Tanner came up and made a tackle. You ain't even punch at the ball. You try to strip it late. Punch and come out ripping. Said, there you go. Good job, Devon. Good job. Good, good. Great center. I got you. What we got?
When I first fell in love with football, I was 8 years old. I had just moved in with my grandmother, and I hadn't played any organized sports ever. And I can remember coming from my third grade class. Mr. John Nezalis was my third grade teacher. And we had a game of kickball that day, and I was the fastest kid in my class, and we were running around. We had a good time, and I had like the game-winning kickball catch, and I just had a bunch of energy. And my grandmother had came to the school that day, and Mr. Nezalis knew how much energy I had in class, and he just told my grandmother, like, you may want to sign him up for an organized sport. He's really athletic. He's very bright, but he just has a lot of energy. My grandmother, she wanted me to have really good grades, and I didn't have good grades at that moment in time. So her promise to me was, I'll sign you up for these organized sports. I'll sign you up for football specifically. And I just need you to take care of your business in the classroom. So she signs me up for football, and I'm really good at it. I happen to be really good at it. But my first report card was horrible. So immediately, she said, you ain't playing football no more. And I can remember crying for like a week, and I was just devastated. I went from a DF student within a course of a semester to literally an AB student, because the thing that motivated me was I was just a very hyperactive kid, and I needed to play, I needed to run around. She kind of dangled that fruit in my face, and I ended up getting really good grades and just being exceptional in football, and that kind of opened the door for a lot of opportunity moving forward.
You gotta go!
Hey, you go better, Babs. Better. Don't cross your feet over though. It should be.
For me, it just gave me a release from reality. You know, my mom was kind of running the streets a little bit. My dad was in and out of prison, and my grandmother was looking after me. And so, for me, it was just an escape. It was a way to get away. It was a way to take my mind off reality. And what ended up happening is falling in love with something that I could control. Or I felt like I could control on that football field, because I had a lot of anger, a lot of aggression, a lot of, I just played with a lot of violence, just that was built up from things in my childhood. Because I felt like I could control it, I felt like I dictated my future. I just genuinely felt like outside of the football field, nothing else could go wrong. You know, like, okay, my mom wasn't in my life, my dad wasn't in my life. Like, what's the worst that could happen if I just go out here and bust my butt on the football field? We tell our players to move on from wins and losses, as they should. As coaches, it's probably a little easier for us to move on just because, hey, man, we got to get you guys ready. We got to get your minds right for the following week. But as players, I know for me as a player, I just hung on to losses just a little more, because I just felt like, what could I have done better, you know, to put myself and put my team in a better position to go out there and win? But I think that love is sometimes tested just simply based off those hardships that you face when you do lose a game. And so I'm constantly affirming them that I love them, constantly affirming that I care about them, because you can make a decision during the course of a game, like pull a kid, because you don't see him displaying his best ability. And he may think, coach hates me. And if you don't talk to him after practice, you don't talk to him after the game, or you don't talk to him leading up to the next game, he may think that you don't care and you're for self, you know, and on top of trying to win. in his mind, he can be thinking something completely different. But I try to tell my guys every single day, every meeting we have, at the end of every practice, that I love them, that I care about them, how much I appreciate them. I just think you can do no wrong in doing that. And not only saying it, but showing it.
The coolest thing about the Wolfpack, coolest thing, is that they always on the hunt. Always, 24/7 on the hunt. All right, and y'all gotta treat life like that. You gotta treat your academics like that. You gotta treat football like that. Cause if you constantly on the hunt, I promise you, if you constantly yearn for more, if you constantly, man, I can get better. If you constantly in that mindset, guess what you're gonna do? You're gonna get better. But as soon as we start to become complacent, oh, I ain't gonna watch film this week. I ain't gonna do everything we're supposed to do. They got me on a special team. That's good enough. I ain't gonna try to be on all four of them. God forbid I'm on all four of them. I might get too tired to play defense. Nobody cares about that, man. Nobody cares about it. You gotta take it upon yourself as individuals to step up to that challenge and to constantly be on the hunt, constantly. I love you guys. I care about you guys too much to let you get complacent and not do the job that you're capable of doing. So when I see something in you and you ain't doing it the way I think you can do it, and I feel like I need to change that, I'm gonna do it. And that's just part of my love for you, because I think you are a much better player than that. But you gotta take ownership in that and wanna elevate your play and love the game that much and love and respect me that much that you're willing to do it.
So Leary out of the shotgun, he'll hand it away to Trent Penix around the left side. Penix cut down, shy of the 30-yard line at about the 28, and that will be the final play as the clock goes to zero. For this young Wolfpack team, they came in very young, very outmanned in a lot of different areas, lost a couple of more players in this ball game. But the thing that we saw in the second half was they didn't fold up. They continued to compete, and they basically played Clemson pretty much easy.
Look at me. Where do we go from here, man? Where we go? Oh. We got three games left. Three games. Louisville, Georgia Tech, North Carolina. All winnable games. Right?
Sure.
Three games. We're playing to try to get into a bowl game right now. That's what we're doing. All right? We got three of them. We got some guys beat up right now, don't we? Huh?
Sure.
Mentally beat up, physically beat up, disappointed, mad, angry. Coaches, players, well, you know what? The only way to fix it is to go win a game. It's the only way. The good news is you can. Family on two, one, two!
Family!
Get 0 for 72 on select F-150s or get $11,500 in total savings at your Carolina Ford dealer.
In America, we make our own decisions and enjoy freedom of choice. For too long, power companies have put profits first, and customers and the environment last. At Power Home Solar, we'll build a world where homes and businesses run on affordable, clean, renewable solar energy. A world we're proud to pass to our children. We're an American company using American-made panels. We're building a movement. One business, one home, one panel at a time. Power Home Solar. Own your power.
For years, you've relied on your electric cooperative to power your daily life. Now, we're going one step further. North Carolina's electric cooperatives are building a network of electric vehicle charging stations across the state, boosting tourism and economic opportunities, reducing emissions, and empowering our members with the latest technology. Learn more at ncdriveelectric.com.
I see a race car. I see a dinosaur.
Hey, Lou, what do you see?
I see a house with a CPI security system, fully equipped with smart video, intrusion protection, and real-time response.
Whoa, cool.
Protect your home with smarter security from CPI. Stop imagining peace of mind. You'll never miss a thing, and one app controls it all. Make CPI yours today. To learn more, go to mycpi.com.
Luke, my T-Rex is going into your house.
He's going to set off the alarm.
This portion of One with Wolfpack Football is presented by Coca-Cola. When you are stocking up for game day, be sure to grab a Coke and share it with a friend. Share a Coke and go Pack.
My grandma used to always tell me, she said, to appreciate the sun, you have to know what rain is. You know, when people don't see it, especially people outside the building, and sometimes our kids don't even see it. They just see the immediate reaction of a loss. You know, man, I studied my butt off this week in preparing for an opponent. Man, I thought I knew the game plan. Man, I didn't play that well. Well, why is it? You know, let's make sure we fix the little things, and are you consistent with that plan? Like, is it something that just happened over the course of the week, or is it something that happened 4 weeks prior to? You know, when I just genuinely believe when you're in a rut of things like this and things aren't going your way, I really believe you find out who your guys are. And it's better to know who they are when the times get tough than not know who they are at all. I think you really find out what kind of character you have as a coach. You find out what kind of character your players have. And when we talk about, hard, tough together just can't be a mantra that's convenient when you're winning. You know, hard, tough together got to be a lifestyle. I mean, guys are going to leave this place and they're going to graduate and they're going to face hardships in their lives. They may get fired. They may be laid off in some capacity in regards to some other work. They may lose some investments if they invest in some things. So how are you going to handle it? How are you going to deal with it? And how are you going to persevere through it at the end of the day?
Football is everything, pretty much. I mean, it's who we are as a family. It's what we do, you know, all year long. It's what we dedicate ourselves to. It's what we dedicate our lives to, like our family. It's what we put our time into. It's helped us meet new people, build new relationships. It's helped us open new opportunities and doors to get to different levels of our life and have different opportunities to open up because of football. And, you know, it just crazy to think that a game has been able to do what it's done for us. And, you know, it's a blessing to be where we are today because of football.
My daily actions, you know, reflect my passion and love for football. You know, I just feel like football is always and will be in our bloods. We have a little brother, too, that we go support every, like, you know, we go watch him play every Thursday night. You know, we travel wherever he's playing. We usually go. You know, that just shows how much, you know, just sports in general, you know, means to us. I just think sports in general is like one of the best things this, you know, this life has to offer, because it just brings, you know, together a bunch of guys that, you know, probably wouldn't meet if it wasn't for sports. So you gain brothers, you gain friends, you gain lifelong memories. And so I just think that's one of the, you know, best things about it.
It's a man's game. It's competitive. It's pressure cooked, you know. It's exhilarating, it's defeating, it's agonizing, and sometimes it's all those things in one day. You know, so it's a roller coaster, but it's the awesomest thing there is, you know. And it's the most gratifying thing there is when you overcome the adversity that we're going to have to overcome this year right now, whether we win or lose. Just we get better and better and better and better.